Okay, so for today, we're going to look into triple integral in cylindrical coordinate as well as spherical coordinate. Okay, so I won't be doing all the exercises lah because kalau nak sentuh dodo ni, tak ada masa lah nak jawab setiap soalan. Okay, however, if you have problems in any of the questions, you may ask that. Okay, we skip the exercise 4.6.1. Okay, because it is only the conversion of rectangular to cylindrical coordinates. So, I believe you can do all, the conversion. We go straight to the triple integral in cylindrical coordinate, which is 4.6.2. Okay. Okay, so we have 13 questions here. 1 and 2 is only iterated integral. Means you integrate respect to z, r and theta one by one. Okay, so yang ini saya tak buat lah, saya rasa tak masalah. And then let's see question number 3 and 4. Because 3 and 4, there are no limits. Okay, you have to determine the limits yourself. And before determine the limits, you have to sketch lah. Okay, to know the region R specifically. Because the region R will be converted into R dr d theta. Okay, which makes it a cylindrical coordinate. Okay. The solid that is enclosed by the paraboloid z equals to 2x squared plus y squared and the plane z equals to x. Okay, yang ini pun saya rasa tak masalah juga ni, senang je. Okay. Remember, you have to know how to sketch. Okay, so you have a paraboloid. Paraboloid tu je, kalau dalam 2D dia parabola. Parabola ni dia ada dua je lah. Sama ada dia senyum atau dia masam tu kan. Okay, and then this one is senyum because it is positive kan. Okay, so dia naik ke atas. Tetapi dia berhenti pada z equals to 18. So here is z equals to 18. Okay. So your projection on the xy plane will be a circle, kan? Which is this circle. Saya buat keluar, dia project pada xy plane. Bawa ada satu circle. Okay, now you have to determine the circle. What is the radius of the circle? Okay, you ada z equals to 18. Circle tu, the circle happens when your z is equals to 18 right now, kan? So you substitute z equals to 18 into the z equals to 2x squared plus y squared, okay? So we'll have 2 okay, so the radius for your circle is 3. Okay, so the 3 is will be your r lah directly. So you ada dia suruh cari volume. So volume in 3D is the integrand is equals to 1. Okay. So dz r dr d theta. So actually this r you can bring to the front lah. Darabkan sekali dengan satu tu. Okay, your z, you walk along the z axis. You'll find z equals to not 0. Okay, not 0. Because if it's 0, then it's a plane on the xy plane means. Okay, now you didn't find the xy plane, you find this paraboloid again. You nampak lengkung tu terus. Okay, so the curve will be z equals to 2x squared plus y squared, which is 2r squared. Okay, you change this one into cylindrical coordinate until z equals to 18. And then the r, this dr d theta, you look into your 2D, which is the region R, no longer on your 3D. Okay, so you nak senang, you jangan tengok pada 3D dah. 3D tu hanya untuk limit yang pertama saja. Limit kedua dan ketiga, tengok pada 2D. Now your region R in 2D is from 0 until 3, and then the theta is 0 to pi, the whole circle, the full circle. Okay, so this is what you want to evaluate. So you may try, eh. Evaluation saya bagi pada awak je lah, tak ada masalah saya rasa kat sini. Jawapan dia apa tadi? Suppose you find the answer, x one pi. Okay. Okay, now let's look question number 4 again. A solid that is bounded by the paraboloid. Another paraboloid. But now the paraboloid is the one facing down z-axis, negative z-axis kan? Okay, yang masam lah, yang masam kiranya sebab dia ada negatif. Okay, and then the above is 16. So sampai sini 16 dia akan turun. Tapi dia turun sampai mana? Dia tak turun sampai bawah lah. It is on the xy plane here. So this is your xy plane. Means z equals to 0. Okay, so this is the z equals to 16 minus y squared plus y squared. Okay, again, your R region, the 2D region is a circle, another circle. So whenever you have your 2D region as a circle, you convert your equations into either polar coordinate for 2D or cylindrical coordinate for 3D. Okay? So kalau nampak je region tu circle, ada dua ni je lah kena guna. Sama ada polar coordinate untuk dua untuk double integral ataupun cylindrical coordinate untuk triple integral. So actually triple integral ni adalah cylindrical coordinate ni adalah polar coordinate dalam 3D. Okay, because dia cuma tukar part 2D dia saja. Part 3D dia Z masih juga sama dengan Z. Okay, now find volume. Okay, so as you walk along Z axis, you will find the XY plane, which is Z equals to 0 until Z equals to 16 minus R squared. Okay, your R again to the region, which is okay, you have to find the radius for your circle. So this circle happens when z equals to 0. Yang ni tadi, circle tu berlaku apabila z sama 18 kan? Tetapi soalan nombor 4 ni, circle tu berlaku apabila z sama 0. So you have to substitute z equals to 0 lah. So you have x squared plus y squared equals to 16. So this is 4. Okay, radius 4. Again, you may try the integration. You shall find your answer to be 128. Okay. Okay, let's do question number 5. Use cylindrical coordinate to evaluate the integral. So, question number 5, all the integral is in xyz, okay? However, the question asks you to change into cylindrical coordinates. So, you have to change the xy into r and theta. Okay, remember, in cylindrical coordinate, you only have r, theta, and z. Okay, r, theta, and z. No longer y, no longer x. Okay. Okay, let's see this 2D region first. So, senangnya you lukis pada 2D region, you nampak circle lawak tu macam mana. Okay. Okay, it goes dy first and then dx. So, dy is here. So when it goes dy, dia akan jumpa y equals to 0 until the y equals to this one. Okay, so this is y, this is x. And then the x from here, dia akan jumpa x sama dengan negatif 1 hingga x sama dengan 1. So this whole semicircle lah, okay. Okay, so if it's a semicircle, then the theta will be from 0 until pi on the end. Okay, so we change to, we know that it is from 0 to pi, and then the r is 0 to 1.
So dz still dz, r dr d theta. However, the z here y, remember I said they are no longer y, they are only r theta and z. So y is equal to r sine theta. Okay, you use the conversion. Okay, x equals to r cos theta, y equals to r sine theta, and z equals to z. Use this conversion to change from dz dy dx to dz r dr d theta. Okay, remember there's r here, so buat kat sini lah. Okay, so you may try. 2 over 3. Okay, now we look into the 2D first, this one. So it goes on dx first, okay. Dia pergi jalan dx, yang ini dahulu tengok. And then it finds this curve, which is the negative curve. And then it finds this positive curve, okay. However, bila dia jalan daripada y, dia tak jumpa bawah ni. Okay, dia jumpa kosong ni dahulu kan, okay. So, the r is actually semicircle above. Sama macam soalan nombor 5 tadi tu juga eh. So dz r dr d theta. So the dr is from 0 to 3 because x equals to 9 minus y squared, okay, so if you square both sides, we get, which is x squared plus y squared equals to 9. So the circle is, has radius 3. And then the theta also 0 to 5. Okay, only semicircle. And then the z just change this equation into cylindrical equation, which is 0 until 9 minus 3r. Okay, because the x squared plus y squared square root is actually equals to r. Okay, this you should get the answer as 27 pi over 2. Okay, question number 7. So you have a integrand there, x squared. Okay, yang soalan nombor 5, 6 tadi tak ada integrand kan? So when you don't have integrand, which is your integrand equals to 1, means you are trying to find the volume. However, if you have integrand, like question number 7, it is no longer a volume lah. Okay, it represents another applications. Okay, kalau application lain dia memang ada function yang diintegratkan. Okay, about application kita akan tengok minggu depan eh. Okay. So again, I will look into the 2D region only because the z will be equal to z. Kan? Cuma kita kena tukar the x and y into r cos theta or r sin theta. Okay. Tapi yang dua yang terakhir ni the crucial lah in cylindrical coordinate because it will change the x and y totally. Okay. Dia bukan lagi square root square root dah. Okay. The questions. Dia akan jalan pada y dahulu. It works along y axis first. therefore the dy. So as it walks along y axis, it will meet the y equals to 0 here, and then the curve here, which is y equals to square root 4 minus x squared. Okay, and then as it walks along dx here, it will meet, dia terjumpa yang ni, dia jumpa this one, which is x equals to 0 until x equals to 2 here. So it is a quarter circle. Okay, it's no longer semicircle, it's quarter circle. Eh?
The x squared will be r cos theta squared. And then dia ada r lagi kan? Okay, so dz dr d theta.
Okay, so r first is 0 to 2, and then theta is 0 to pi over 2, which is a quarter. And then the z is from 0 until 4 minus r squared. You tukar yang ini. Plus yang ini ada 4 tolak x squared plus y squared kalau you tulis dalam bracket. Okay, so it will be 4 minus r squared. Okay, so actually this one you boleh darab dulu. You permudahkan dulu, you simplify everything that you can simplify before you go on with integration. Okay, so you have r squared and then times another r, so ada r kuasa 3 lah. Cos kuasa 2 theta dz dr d theta. Okay, so this one, the cos squared theta ni, use identity. Okay, change it into 1 plus cos 2 theta over 2, then you integrate. Okay, change to identity first, then integrate. Eh? So, let me try here. The answer is 4 pi over 3. Okay, let's look the region 2D. So the question walks along x-axis first. So you have the x there. As it walks along x-axis, it meets x equals to 0 here, and then x equals to this curve, which is x equals to 4 minus 4 squared square root. And then walking along y-axis, dia akan jumpa negative 2 until 2. So, it has this semicircle on the x-axis positive. Okay. And then it has the integrand xz. So, xz pun kena tukar juga. Eh? So, x is r cos theta. Z is z. And then dz, remember, they have r dr d theta. Okay, so actually r ni boleh darab. The z will be from r until 2. The r and theta, you don't have to look into here, but look into your region here, region r, which is the r is 0 to 2. The theta is, so this one is negative pi over 2 until pi over 2. Okay. So, saya permudahkan dulu r kuasa 2 cos theta z. Z dr d theta. Okay, so you solve for z first and then dr and then d theta. And let's see, we get the answer 64 over 50. Whichever part that I ask you to try, please try, eh? Okay, equation number 9. Find the volume between the parabolic. There are two parabolic here. Okay, the first parabolic is smile and the sinuum one, which is z equals to x squared plus y squared. So your identity is here is z equals to x squared plus y squared. And then the second parabolic is masamila, which is sinuum part, katilah sinuum part. So you actually you have something like this. Okay, let's say you have something like this.
Okay, so you want to find the
volume of this para two parabolic. Ini sepeda, sebagai tanah. Belah-belah ni semua tanah. Okay, so yang atas ni adalah z equals to 4 minus x squared minus y squared. Yang bawah tu adalah z equals to x squared plus y squared. Okay, let's say you have something like this. Okay, so the circle, again on projection on the 2D plane, you have this circle kan? Which is on 2D, you have the circle. Okay, what is the radius of the circle? Okay, the circle happens when both parabolic collide kan? Bila parabolic kedua-dua itu, orang kata menyentuh. Okay, bertemu. Now, we substitute, then we have z, x equals to 4 minus x squared minus y squared equals to x squared plus y squared. Let's say this is the z1 equals to the z2. The parabolic 1 equals to the parabolic 2 because we want to find the intersection. The intersection here. I have 2x squared plus 2y squared equals 2, which is x squared plus y squared equals 2. Okay, so this is your radius, which is square root 2 lah. Okay, and then the question asks to find volume. So below find volume means tengah-tengah tu satu. Integrand is equals to 1. So dz, r, dr, d theta. Okay, so we find the r d theta first because it is only looking to this 2D region. Okay, we have 0 to square root 2 until 0 to 2 pi because the whole circle, okay? Okay, now our z is when we move from z-axis negative to z-axis positive. Okay, so bila kita jalan daripada bawah Z tu, paksi Z, kita akan jumpa lengkung yang pertama. Lengkung yang pertama is X squared plus Y squared. So, X squared plus Y squared is actually equals to R squared. Okay, change into cylindrical coordinate. And then, as we walk along lagi, kita akan jumpa lengkung yang kedua. Jangan ambil empat. Okay, because four is actually a plan. Maknanya satu plan macam awak imagine kertas A4 pada terdampar pada Z equals to 4. Okay, now, there are no plan. What we have is a curve. Okay, what is the equation for the curve? Equation for the curve is 4 minus x squared minus y squared, which is 4 minus r squared lah. Okay. Bila saya buat kurungan, actually yang tolak tu jadi tambah. So, bila tukar dia jadi 4 tolak r kuasa 2. So, this is what you want to integrate. So, r ni darab je lah kat sini. Okay, I think there will be no problem from here. You will find the answer equals to 4 pi. Okay, question number 10. Use cylindrical coordinate to evaluate, okay, the integrand x squared plus y squared, square root, where g is the region enclosed by the plane and by the cylinder. So x squared plus y squared, square root is actually r. So when changing to cylindrical coordinate, we'll have dz, r, dr, d theta. So this r actually can be multiply. Okay, so kalau
tak lukis benda ni pun kita boleh tahu kan. Okay, the z is from 0 until x plus y plus 5. Okay, z tu daripada 0 hingga x tambah y tambah 5. Apa dia x tambah y tambah 5 ni? Converting into cylindrical coordinate, we will have r cos theta plus r sin theta plus 5. Okay, then these two, you lukis apa yang dia bagi, which is one, you have a circle with radius 2. And then another one is a circle with radius 3. Because x squared plus y squared equals to 9. So your r is from 2 to 3. Okay? And then dia tadi cakap pun kuadran pertama, kuadran ketiga, region apa semua. So it is from 0 until 2 pi. The whole surface. Okay? So what you want to integrate is actually 0, r cos theta plus r sin theta plus 5, r squared plus 1, you multiply, so dz, okay. Ini pun saya tengok ada masalah lah ni. Okay, do the integration one by one. Dia memang panjang sikit, tapi as long as you do one by one, you integrate respect to z, masuk nilai. Integrate respect to r, you masuk nilai. Integrate respect to theta, then you masuk nilai, then you get the final answer. The final answer should be 190 pi over. Okay, so I'll give you a kickstart on how to start your exercise. And then you may do the calculation yourself lah. Okay, however, you must ensure yourself, how do I get the limits? Okay, do not just ambil je daripada apa yang saya bagi ni, tapi mesti tahu kenapa jadi seperti itu. Okay, sebab nanti dalam final saya tak boleh tolong awak macam ni. You have to help yourself. Okay. Okay, question 11. Use cylindrical coordinate to evaluate another enclosed by the paraboloid cylinder and the xy plane. Okay. So your region 2D is a circle of radius 5. Okay, no, so 0 to 5 until 0 to 5. Now the Z. The Z, they are the checkup from XY plane. XY plane is Z equals to 0. Until the paraboloid. Paraboloid is Z equals to 1 plus X squared plus Y squared, which is 1 plus R squared. Baik. Kadang-kadang you tak perlu untuk 3D ni, you tak perlu nak lukis pun tak apa. Yang penting 2D. Okay, tapi make sure you know, you understand the whole situation, the whole equation. Okay. Sebab dia tak ada Z lain lagi dah. Dia ada Z yang itu saja. So kalau you lukis pun actually dia adalah senyum tapi naik satu kan. Senyum naik satu. Okay, tapi dia tak sampai atas. This is the cylinder of the jari 5 tu. Okay, so dia nak suruh awak cari volume yang apa? Volume yang ini lah. Merah ni. Sebab tu bila awak jalan daripada Z, awak akan jumpa yang XY plane 0 ni dulu, baru awak jumpa yang ni. Okay, tidak termasuk yang atas tu. Okay, so actually you don't have to sketch pun tak apa, as long as you know apa question tu nak. Okay. So, ni pun saya rasa tak masalah eh. Okay, since we have only two questions more, kita selesaikan eh.
Okay, integrate with respect to Z, then the exponent has Z. Okay, integrate exponent dapat exponent lah juga. Exponent ni paling senang. Integrate exponent dapat exponent, differentiate exponent pun dapat exponent. Cuma you kena tengok balik kuasa dia. Now the power of the exponent is Z kan, Z itself. So, bawa ke bawah pun jadi satu. So, tak ada masalah lah. The R, exponent Z, 0 minus plus R squared. Okay, exponent 1 plus r squared minus exponent 0. Exponent 0 is actually equals to 1. Okay, so saya darab dulu, senang. Sebab yang depan tu, dia berbeza dengan belakang tu. So, the one here, you have to use substitution. Okay, but this one is direct integration only. Okay, so let's say I use a substitution, let u equals to 1 plus r squared. Okay, you take the power of the exponent to be u. Okay, not the r. So kalau u ambil r, dia no point lah. Dia tak ada beza gitu. So du dr is actually equals to 2r, which is r dr actually equals to 1 over 2. So R dr has become 1 over 2 du. 1 over 2 exponent u du. Saya kena beza dah ni. So yang ini jadi dia jadi R dr kuasa 2 per 2 kosong 5. And this one, you belum integrate lagi eh. You baru tukar saja. So, bila you nak integrate, you akan keluarkan exponent u lah juga. What is the u? U is 1 plus r squared. Okay, then you masuk nilai 0.5. Pula, ni tadi pun sama. Kuasa 2 per 2, you masuk nilai 0.5. So, 5 to the power of 2 is 25. 25 plus 1, 26. Exponent 26 minus exponent 0, exponent 1 minus 25 over 2 minus 0. So, theta. And then, dia tak ada apa-apa, tinggal theta saja. Terus dia bawa keluar 1 ke 2. Dan ada eksponen 26, tolak eksponen, tolak 25. And then theta is from 0 to 2 pi. 26 minus exponent minus 25. 2 pi minus 0 to pi. So, potong daripada exponent 26. Exponent 25. Okay, so, or you can write in terms of decimal point pun boleh. Tak kisah eh. But this is the answer in your, in the answer sheet. Okay, so kalau decimal point, apa berapa? Oh, power dia besar sangat. To the power of 11. So, tulis macam ni je lah. Okay, this is question number 11. Use cylindrical coordinate to find volume. Again, another volume of a curve which cut out from a cylinder and the planes. Okay. So the cylinder is actually not on the 0, 0 and the near center. The center is on 2, 0. So let's say here 2, 2, 0. You have a contour cylinder macam ni lah. Okay. It is actually on the x-axis. Now, it being cut by z equals to 0, z equals to 0 bawah ni, which is the xy plane. And z equals to negative y. Z equals to negative y, maksudnya dia macam ni lah. Then dia panjang-panjang ni jadi kena potong. So actually you ada something like this, eh. Kau cuba keluar. Plane dia potong kat sini, eh. So ini adalah panjang. Condong. So condong ni is that equals to negative one. Okay, so your region R is only in this area. Ya, kalau you buat keluar, you akan jumpa it is on the y negative y axis, which is here lah. Dia sebenarnya ada bulatan macam ni, which is this is 2 tadi, tapi region R awak cuma belah sini sebab dia dah terpotong dengan z equals to negative y. Okay. So to find the volume, this one is R dr d theta. So the z jalan daripada bawah, z equals to 0 until z equals to negative y, which is negative r sine theta. And then the dr d theta you refer to here. Okay. Apakah persamaan equation ini? Okay, if you still remember on the topic 1.5, which is the polar coordinate, okay, you have equals to r equals to a cos theta for a circle on the x-axis, positive. What is a? Okay, a is the value of here lah. So kalau dia punya ni 2, tambah lagi 2, so sini adalah 4. Okay, so actually you have r equals to 4 cos theta. So you have to refer back. If you forget about this, refer back to topic 1.5. Okay. You have the r equals to a cos theta, r equals to negative a cos theta, r equals to a sin theta, and r equals to negative a sin theta. So difference. Okay. Dia ikut bulatan tu sama ada kat sini ke, kat sini, sini ataupun kat sini. Dia different daripada yang center punya. Center punya is r equals to a. Okay, so yang ni dia dah patah balik ni. Ini you kena tengok balik, eh. Okay, then you have r equals to 4 cos theta, which is your r from 0 until 4 cos theta. And then your theta. Your theta, remember, eh, dia occupies only this area. This area is from 3 pi over 2 until 2 pi, kan? Tapi bila nak buat integration, you tak boleh ambil daripada besar, kecil ke besar, kan? You kena ambil, this is negative pi over 2 until 0. Okay. So here actually, here is negative pi over 2 until pi over 2. However, it only occupies this area. So negative pi over 2 until 0. So you may try to find the answer. Saya rasa tak masalah dia ni, ni boleh darab. And then you integrate bezel. I think you have to use substitution here. Okay. Yeah, you kena guna substitution sebab nanti you akan ada cos dengan sin. Sin theta ada, cos theta pun ada. So you kena substitution kat sini, eh. And then the answer is equal to 16 over.
Okay, remember eh, this one pun selalu student silap. Kalau even though dia punya circle tu full kat sini, dia bukan kosong hingga 2 pi. Bukan. Sebab dia adalah daripada negative pi per 2 hingga pi per 2 saja. Untuk setiap region tu, dia memang ada dia punya angle. So this one is from 0 to pi over 2. And then this one is from pi over 2 until pi ni semua tahu lah kan. And then this one is from pi until 3 pi over 2. And then this one from 3 pi over 2 until 2 pi or negative pi over 2 until pi over 2. Depends lah. Okay. So if your circle occupies only this area, even though the circle is full, dia bukan sampai kosong hingga 2 pi. Dia cuma hanyalah daripada kosong hingga pi per 2. Because it's only on the kuadran yang pertama. Faham eh? Sama juga kalau awak punya circle tu cuma pada yang ini saja. Kuadran ketiga. So kuadran ketiga, even though the circle is full, it's not from 0 to 2 pi. Okay? The angle must refers to the quadrant. Which quadrant that your curve occupies. Okay? Okay, let's see last question in cylindrical coordinate, which is question number 13. Find the volume of the... solid bounded above and below by the sphere and inside the cylinder. Saya tak nampak, saya lukis dulu eh. Kalau you boleh nampak, you tak boleh lukis pun tak apa. Ini saya tak berapa nak ni. Find the volume of the solid above and below by the sphere. So, awak ada sphere. Jejari dua. Silinder. Silinder. Jejari satu. The bond. Okay. Okay, so dia tak nak yang belah sini semua dia tak nak. Belah ni pun dia tak nak. Dia nak belah tu tetapi atas yang ini ada sebahagian daripada sphere tadi kan? X squared plus Y squared plus Z squared plus 4. Yang ini pun adalah sebahagian daripada yang ini tadi. So cuma yang tengah-tengah ni sahaja yang X squared plus Y squared plus 1, which is the cylinder. Okay. Okay, so you punya projection is a circle. However, your circle is not dua lah. Circle awak mesti refer pada cylinder ni lah. So, cylinder tu je yang full kan. So, circle to cylinder is actually radius 1. We'll have, is it the full circle? Volume lah, okay, volume, full circle. So volume equals to, Z, jalan daripada bawah, di Z dia akan jumpa not the cylinder. Sebab dia akan jumpa yang merah ni tadi. Which is half of the, part of the sphere kan. Part of the sphere is this one lah. Tapi yang bawah ni adalah negative part. So, maksudnya Z equals to 4 minus X squared minus Y squared square root negative. And then yang atas ni adalah positive part. 4 minus X squared minus Y squared square root. Okay. So, kalau nak tukar dalam cylindrical coordinate, kita buat kurungan lah. Okay. So, yang akan dapat macam ni. Negative 4 minus R squared square root. Okay. Lagi satu saya perlu tekankan. Yang ini tidaklah menjadi 2 tolak R. Yang ini pun tidaklah menjadi negatif 2 tolak R. Okay, jangan suka-suka hati square rootkan the 4 minus R squared. Because it has a tambah tolak kan? Dia ada tambah tolak. Tambah tolak, you tak boleh buat square macam tu saja. Okay, you tak boleh square root macam tu saja. Kecuali kalau dia hanyalah 4R kuasa 2 kuasa 2. Ha, barulah jadi 2R. Boleh. Okay. Yang atas tu tak betul eh. Memang saya ramai, saya nampak ramai yang buat macam tu but it is wrong. Okay. Even though many people do it like that, what's wrong is still wrong. Okay. Okay, so the Z is from negative
4 minus r squared until 4 minus r squared square root positive, and then the r is 0 to 1, and then the theta is 0 to 5.
This is the last question. Last question, so kita buatlah. Okay, this question also has a substitution. And the substitution technique is very important. Eh? You have, I think, 3 or 4 questions of substitution technique in your final exam. So it is very crucial for you to understand the substitution technique. Okay, how to do it. Okay, not just the direct integration. Eh? Kalau tak, you tak boleh jawab 3 atau 4 soalan ni. Kalau you tak tahu substitution technique. Then you boleh belajar lagi lah, okay, kalau you rasa tak tahu. Okay, let's solve this one. Okay, so integral respect to Z, you ada Z sajalah. So R tadi masih ada. So, tolak-tolak jadi tambah. So, dia akan jadi 2. Okay, so actually these two I can bring outside. So, dia cuma constant. And then you boleh bawa keluar sebab semua tu darab saja. Kalau tambah tolak, you jangan bawa keluar. Eh. Sama juga macam tadi. Tambah tolak, you tak boleh square root kan. Okay, so this part you have to use substitution. Okay, let's say that ambil dalam saja. Okay, so the RDR will be negative 1 over 2 du, say what word u, and then the u will be square u. Okay. So negative 1 over 2 ni pun boleh buat keluar. We'll have negative only. Okay, so the u 1 over 2 plus 1 over 1 over 2 plus 1. So this one is 3 over 2, or it will be 2 over 3 here. Yeah? Okay, remember before you substitute the value of this 0 to 1, this 0 to 1 is for r. Okay, so you have to change back the u into r. Okay, jangan substitute terus kat sini. Kalau you substitute kat sini, memang salah. Which is the r is 4 minus r squared. To the power of 3 over 2. If you want to skip any parts here, yang parts-parts sini ni nak skip pun tak apa. You terus masukkan lah. Okay, so 4 minus r squared. Empat. 1 kuasa 2, 1, 4, 1, 3. 3 kuasa 3 per 2. 3 kuasa 3 per 2 sama dengan 7 kuasa 27.
kosong 4 kuasa 3 per 2 sama dengan tolak 8. Jadi theta. So 2 per 3. So saya nak hilangkan negatif ni, saya tukar sini lah. So theta is from 0 to 2 pi. Dah habis ni jawapannya. 2 pi minus 0 means 0. So, lebih cantik dapatlah 4 pi per 3. 8 tolak. 7 kuasa 27.
Okay, 7 kuasa 27 tu samalah juga dengan 3 7 kuasa 3 tu eh. So, this part is very important eh. Substitution technique. Okay, so we have finished with cylindrical coordinate. I shall continue with spherical coordinate. Before that, do you have any questions for cylindrical? Ada soalan tak untuk cylindrical coordinate? Cylindrical coordinate is basically you change the 2D, your 2D region, equals into a polar coordinate. Okay, it means you have R, dr, d theta. Okay, but then your 3D, the z will still be except for that you change all the x and y into r cos theta and r sin theta. Tak ada soalan ya? Okay, let's look into 4.6.4. So here we have 10 questions. Okay, so again saya akan bagi limit je lah mana yang possible, mana yang perlu eh. Sketch the region G and evaluate the iterator integral. Okay, if the question asks you to sketch the region G, means G is surface in 3D. So, kena lukis dalam 3D. Tapi kalau region R is 2D. Okay, so you have to differentiate between region G and region R. Eh? So, lukis saja. Untuk integration tu, you boleh buat sendiri. You can do it for yourself for integration. I will show you how to sketch the region really. So you have a sphere. You have a sphere of radius 2. How do I know it is 2? Because your rho is from 0 until 2. Rho 2 adalah radius untuk sphere, sphere awak eh. Sphere, your sphere. And then the phi is from 0 to pi over 2 and theta is from 0 to pi. Here, let's say this is your 2. Your phi is from 0 to pi over 2. Pi over 2 is only here lah. Kalau bawah ni, dia jadi pi. This is phi equals to pi. This is phi equals to pi over 2. Okay. And then, theta equals to 0 to pi. Theta 0 is here. And then, pi is only here. So, you have a quarter. Is it quarter sphere? 0 to pi is here. Pi, 0. Okay, so. Okay, tapi ada separuh yang ini saja. So, ya, yeah, biar lah. Okay, it's a quarter sphere. Sebab dia ada separuh 1/4 saja daripada sphere awal. Okay, and then the integration you may do it yourself, eh? Use spherical coordinate, question number 2. Use spherical coordinate to find the volume of the solid bounded by the sphere, rho equals to 3, below by the cone. Cone P equals to 5/4. So here the cone. This is the cone.
V equals to 5 over 4. Yang inilah V dia tu. Yeah, V. And then rho equals to 3 is here. Rho equals to 3 maksudnya sphera 1 ni. Double sphera. Okay, so dia ada macam ice cream. This one is rho equals to 3. Okay, so volume is 1. Okay, however, to find the cylindrical spherical coordinate, spherical is rho squared sin phi. Okay, yang ini fix. Okay, memang macam tu formula dia. Rho squared sin phi, d rho, d theta, d phi. Okay, and then these two, you have to distinguish between the angle. Theta is angle on the xy plane. It is the 2D angle. Phi is the angle on the z axis. Okay, difference eh. Okay, so the rho is from 0 to 2 tadi. Rho. 2 to 3. 0 to 3. And then the theta semua ni kan. Projection dia ke bawah ni circle, memang full circle, which is 0 to 2 pi. And then the phi is, dia dah bagi pun 0 to pi apa? 4. Okay, so this is what you want to integrate. The answer is 15 pi minus 1 over square root 2. Okay, question number 3. Use spherical coordinate to find the volume of the solid that lies inside the sphere outside the quad. So you have a sphere, and then you have a cone. Cone tu ada dua kan? That's one. The cone actually infinitely, not infinity. But dia tak beritahu pun nak berhenti kan? Mana. And then the question asks to find the volume of the solid that lies inside sphere, inside sphere circle. Okay, so it asks you to find this volume. Other than the cone, eh? So the cone, we know that it is this one, P equals to 5 over 4. So the theta is this whole, is 0 to 2 pi. The rho is x squared plus y squared plus z squared equals to 4, so 0 to 2. Okay, however, the phi will be different. The phi is from here, which is phi pi over 4 until here. Okay, pi over 4 until... This is another pi over 4. 5, 7 pi over 4. 4 pi. 3 pi over 4. Okay. So this is will be the phi equals to pi n. So dia sampai sini saja. Or, ataupun, awak nak senang yang ini kira, nak senang kira tu. Tak senang juga sebab dia tak sampai kosong. Okay, just left here lah. Okay, you may choose ataupun you boleh ambil separuh daripada sini ke sini saja. Okay, daripada y axis on me from here until here, this phi equals to pi over 2, tapi you kena darab 2. untuk dapatkan atas bawah. Tapi actually sama saja. Okay, my try lah. Either one. Both will give you the same answer, which is 16 over 3 pi square root 2. Okay. Question number 4. So this is converting all the integration to a spherical coordinate. Okay, so spherical coordinate ni dia memang berbeza langsung lah. Dia tak ada z, tak ada y, tak ada x, tak ada y, tak ada z. Okay, what it has is rho, theta and phi. So the conversion will be so you have to look into your image to determine your sphere. Is it a full sphere, semi, or half sphere or quarter sphere? Semua dia bergantung kepada awak punya limit. Eh. So spherical coordinate is actually depends on the sphere. Okay, so if you walk along Z, dia tak jumpa lengkung bawah tu. Dia jumpa lengkung yang kosong ni terus, which is the XY plane, Z equals to 0, and then this one, which is your sphere equals to 1. The radius is okay, on your xy pula, so xy is to determine your theta. Okay, this is for theta limit. Sekarang ni theta awak, kalau dia jalan daripada y, dia akan jumpa y equals to 0 kan? Di sini until y equals to this one. And then bila dia jalan daripada x, dia akan jumpa dari 1 hingga 1. So this is your theta. Means your theta is from 0 until pi only. Tak full lah. Okay. So kalau nak ikutkan lebisan awak tu 0 to pi yang macam soalan pertama tadi lah, half sini saja. Okay. This part nanti. Kita ambil sampai semua eh. So exponent negative rho squared phi over 2 rho squared sin phi. So remember the rho squared sin phi by default memang ada. D rho d theta. So theta tadi kita dah cari, which is 0 to pi. So follow saya, limit theta ni ke tengah-tengah. P is from 0, separuh kan tadi 0 until pi over 2. Okay, because z atas ni sampai bawah ni saja. P is, okay, daripada sini ke sini saja pi awak. And then the rho is the circle, so the sphere 0 until. Actually, I have like this. Huh? Okay, yang ini boleh potong dulu. Kuasa 2 ni potong. Dapatlah rho kuasa 3 saja. Okay, so again, this one you have to use substitution. just one. Okay, so again, remember the substitution. So not let apa, jangan let
raw kuasa 2 tu. Sebab raw kuasa 2 tu kat luar kan, kita kena let the raw to the power of 3. Okay, sebab dia ada kuasa yang tu. Lagipun, bila kita bezakan raw kuasa 3 ni, kita akan dapat 3 raw kuasa 2. Raw kuasa 2 tu ada kat luar tu. So, kita boleh substitute. Okay, so to use substitution, you have to think the one that you want to substitute, bila you bezakan benda tu, okay, when you differentiate that one, the differentiation, the answer for your differentiation ada dekat sebelah dia. Okay, then itulah substitution yang betul lah. So let u equals to rho to the power of 3. We'll have u dy equals to 3 to rho to the power of 2. So rho to the power of 2 kan ada kat sini kan? So betul dah lah ni. Saya kena tukar je supaya rho to the power of 2 tu jadi subjek dia. So tukarlah rho kuasa 2 di rho sama dengan 1 per 3 di u. So then you can substitute. Remember to look into substitution technique if you think you're weak in this technique. So substitute, you have exponent negative u because the rho to the power of 3 has become u. Rho squared d rho, then v ni kita bawa keluar dulu. Okay, kita gabungkan yang ni. You akan dapat 1 over 3 du. So sin v tu kat belakang, d theta kat belakang, d phi kat belakang. So kita akan solve yang ini dahulu. So senang ni. Sebab eksponen, bezakan ke, integratekan ke, you akan dapat eksponen juga. Cuma negatif dia. Okay, so dia akan bawa ke depan lah. Actually dia bawa ke bawah. Tapi bila dia bawa ke bawah, dia jadi negatif 1 pun sama juga. Okay. Okay, so actually this one you can directly different integrate. Yang ni pun boleh direct integrate sebab dia tak ada campur dah. Okay, before anything, change the u into rho to the power of 3. The sign will become negative cos v. V is from v kat belakang sekali, cosine ke pi over 2. And then the theta is from 0 to. So, dah semua dah integrate ni. Kena masuk nilai and then masuk nilai and then darab saja. So, you'll have your answer to be ni try lah kat sini eh. Pi over 3 1 minus 1 over. Question number 5. Okay, 5, 6, 7 ni semua lebih kurang. Okay, cuma perlu ganti saja. Remember jangan terus ganti main masuk je. You kena lukis balik you punya limit tu. Sebab it is totally different. The spherical is totally different. For cylindrical, you can choose to sketch the 2D. Macam saya buat tadi. Sketch the 2D je dah cukup. Z tu boleh tukar je. Okay. But then for spherical, the whole thing is different. Okay. There are no longer X, Y, Z. Okay. So you kena lukis lah untuk faham apa yang ada sebenarnya ni. Okay. So if you walk along z-axis, tadi dia akan jumpa the z equals to x squared plus y squared is actually a cone kan. Okay, dia akan jumpa cone belah atas and then dia akan jumpa ni ice cream lah ni tadi. Macam ice cream tadi. This is z equals to x minus x squared minus y squared. Then this is z equals to x squared plus y squared. Okay, the xy, you lukis pada xy luar. Dia jalan x dahulu. Dia jalan x, dia akan jumpa x equals to 0. So, dia tak jumpa yang ni.
and then dia akan jumpa this one. Tetapi bila dia jalan y, dia akan jumpa kosong juga. So ni pun dia tak jumpa. So actually this is the only region for r. Okay. Okay, so kita boleh convert kepada spherical coordinate. You have the z squared kan? Z kalau tukar, z equals to rho cos v. So z squared means rho cos v squared. Rho squared sin v by default memang ada. Ini by default. D rho, d theta, d v. Okay. The rho is a square root. Sorry, rho is the radius for your sphere. Now is a 8 kan, which is square root 8. Also hingga square root 8. The theta is here just now, which is 0 until pi over 2. Ini kosong hingga pi over 2 saja. And then the phi is until here lah, yang ini adalah phi. So kalau cone bentuk macam ni, phi dia adalah pi over 4. Okay, so actually this is what you want to integrate. Okay, remember this rho dengan rho ni boleh gabungkan dululah. Simplify. If you can simplify, then you simplify your integrand first. It will be much easier for you to solve your integration. So you have rho to the power of 2, which is rho square, and then another rho square, so 2 tambah 2 jadi 4, so rho to the power of 4. Cos square phi, sin phi, d rho, d theta, d phi. So obviously this one you have to use substitution. Okay, so you may try for substitution technique here. And I will leave you to solve for the whole integration, which you will have to get the answer to be. Okay, remember if you didn't get this answer, macam nampak cantik ni, okay, because sometimes the this one you get when you use a special calculator. Okay, if your calculator didn't come out with this answer, however it comes out with a decimal point answer, it is actually accepted, given that the points, the decimal points, the answer is similar lah, mesti sama. Okay, so maksudnya jawapan dalam decimal point juga diterima, tidak semestinya dalam bentuk set semuanya. So if you get your answer in terms of decimal point, you should get 3.9006, something like that. Okay, so you may try it. We have a few more questions, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Question number 6. Okay, if you look into the limits, it is you can see that it is actually a full sphere kan? Sebab semuanya daripada negative infinity ke infinity, and then second one negative infinity ke infinity, and then negative 3 or 2, 3. So it is actually a full sphere. Okay, memang sphere penuh ni kalau tengok pada limit pun tahu. Okay, so kalau yang penuh ya, senang saja. Yang phi dia mestilah kosong hingga pi, theta dia mestilah kosong hingga 2 pi. Okay, and then the rho depends on the question. So now you have square root 9, so 0 to 3. Okay, the x squared plus y squared plus z squared is actually equal to rho squared. Rho squared square root, you'll have rho. Okay, and then by default, you must have the rho squared sine v, d rho, d theta, d v. So this is actually what you want to integrate. So this rho and rho ni dah boleh jadi ni, darab. So rho kuasa 3, so boleh ni senang. Rho kuasa 3, so when you want to integrate rho to the power 3, we'll have rho to the power 4 over 4, from 0 to 3. And then you integrate theta, you'll get theta, 0 to 2 pi, and then integrate the sine phi, you'll get negative cos phi. Remember, this is integration, so bezel sine, bezel pula, integrate sine akan dapat negative cos, okay? Tapi kalau bezelkan sine, you dapat cos saja, positive cos. So this vice versa. Okay, so you substitute the value, you should get 81 by S in.
Okay, question number 7. It is no longer a full sphere sebab limit pertama dengan kedua tu dia start daripada kosong. Dia bukan start daripada negative infinity. Negative square root. Okay, it doesn't start with negative square root. It start with zero. So, it is half. Okay, half of the sphere or half of the circle. Okay, let me see half letter.
X squared plus Y squared.
Okay, so X squared plus Y squared square root is actually R.
R is rho sine V. Okay, and then rho squared sine V. So this is the X squared plus Y squared square root, right? Which is equal to R. So R equals to rho sine V. And then another rho squared sine V. D rho d theta. So rho is from 0 to 4. How do I know 4? Because it has 16 minus x squared minus y squared. So the say, the radius must be square root 16, which is 4 lah.
Okay, the theta now is no longer full circle. Sebab y, bila dia jalan daripada y, bila dia jalan daripada y, dia jumpa ni dulu baru ni. And then jalan x negative 4 ke 4, so it's this one lah. So theta is from 0 to 5. And then the phi as well. Okay, phi pun sama. Sebab bila dia jalan daripada z, dia akan jumpa z kosong, lepas tu dia jumpa this one. So yang ini adalah phi dia, 0 until 5 over 2.
Okay, so this part saya rasa tak ada masalah dah. Yang ini you multiply first. You ada rho kuasa 3. Beza, integrate dapat rho kuasa 4 tu. 4. Masukkan kosong ke 4. And then theta is theta. Kosong in the pi. But then you have sine, sine lah. Sine, sine jadi sine kuasa 2 lah. Okay, so this sine squared change to identity first. So ini is the second part also. One minus cos 2 phi lah nak, not theta, because it, the variable is phi, so you have to use phi. Cos 2 phi over 2 d phi. So 64 pi, integrate dapat 1 ke 2 theta, minus cos is sine 2 phi over 4. Sebab 2, turun 2 lagi dapatlah. Sin 5 over 2 is 0, minus 0, 64 pi 5 over 4. So 16 pi square. You have your answer 16 pi square, eh?
Okay, question number 8 should be no problem. Okay. Use spherical coordinate to evaluate x squared plus y squared plus z squared is actually rho squared. Rho squared to the power of 2 lagi kat situ. And then rho sine phi is by default 0 d theta d phi. Now we want to determine our limit. Okay, dia kata hemisphere saja ni. So, phi dia kosong hingga 3 sebab square root 9. Theta dia
kosong hingga 2 pi. Theta is for region 2D, 2D region. Okay, memang full. Tetapi yang tak full adalah 3D dia, which is a solid hemisphere, dia separuh saja. So, phi dia adalah sehingga pi per 2. So, darabkan dulu. Yang ini ada rho kuasa 4, dah tambah lagi, darab lagi rho kuasa 2. So, rho kuasa 6, integrate yang akan dapat rho kuasa 7 ke 7. Okay, should be no problem, right? So, akan dapat 3, 7, 4, 7. Okay, from here to here, just substitute the value. Use spherical coordinate to evaluate x, y, z, which is a solid between the sphere and above the cone in first of n. Okay, you ada dua, satu, this one, and then another one, this one. This is two, this is four. And then you ada one. Between the sphere, that one, and above the cone in the first of them. You ada cone lah, jenis. X, Y, Z. Okay, panjang ni. X is rho sin phi cos theta. This is X. Y is rho sin phi sin theta. Name of all, eh? Z is rho cos phi. And then darab lagi yang biasa tu, which is rho squared sin phi d rho d theta. Okay, so we have to determine the rho. Rho ni ada dua sfera, which is sfera pertama, dia cari dua, so dua hingga empat lah. Lepas dia sini dua, sini empat. And then theta, dia ada cakap first of ten sahaja kan. First of ten must be this one only, which is the xy positive. So xy positive is 0 until whatever. Phi, okay, phi sampai sini. Phi ni yang kita kena cari. Okay, because phi is depends on the cone. The cone is z equals to 3x squared plus 3y squared. It is not the normal cone, eh? Kalau normal cone z squared plus equals to x squared plus y squared, then the phi is equals to pi over 4. Tapi ada, dia ada 3 kat situ. So maksudnya bukaan dia berbeza. So you kena cari dia punya dia punya angle, eh? Okay, so macam mana nak cari angle tu? So you ada, you tukarlah kepada cos and phi, eh? So z is z squared, z squared. So z squared, z tadi apa? Z is rho cos phi squared to 3 x squared plus y squared is r squared. R squared is rho sine phi. Rho sine phi squared. Okay, so ini change into this one. So maksudnya itu adalah z kuasa 2 tolak 3. Sama dengan 3, x kuasa 2 tambah y kuasa 2. Okay, so sekarang kita nak cari phi dia sama apa. Okay. So you ada tangent. Tangent phi sama dengan tangent is sine of a cos, kan? Okay, so sine tu ke atas, cos tu ke bawah. So bawa ke sana, yang ini bawa ke sini. 1 per 3 sama dengan rho squared sin squared phi over rho squared cos squared phi. Rho squared boleh mati. So the sine and the cos will be tangent squared phi. Okay, so boleh cari dalam sebelum nak ni sebab dia ada kuasa 2. Okay, so you akan dapat dia sama dengan pi over 6. Okay, so that's how you find your phi, eh? So your phi must be from 0 until pi over 6. Okay, so sekarang dia banyak sangat row ni. Awak kena simplify first before you do anything. Okay. Ini ada 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Row kuasa 5. And then sine kuasa 1, 2, 3, sin kuasa 3, phi, and then cos phi, lagi tak? 4, cos theta, cos theta, sin theta. Okay, ada banyak. Cos theta, sin theta. Okay, so ni, dengan ni beza, dengan ni beza. But then this one, you have to do substitution. This one also you have to use substitution. Okay, sebab yang tu untuk theta, yang satu lagi tu untuk phi. So berbeza, you tak boleh gabung sekali tau sebab dia punya parameter tu berbeza. Okay, so you may solve for this one. Yeah, we leave you for the substitution, do it yourself until you get the answer. Okay, you must get this answer, eh. For apa ni, insyaAllah boleh lah jawab final tu sebab substitution dekat final tu is the crucial things lah, which is I think most of you lack in that part, eh. Okay, we have arrived to our last question, which is question number 10 is spherical coordinate. Find the volume of the solid above the cone and below the plane. Above the cone and below the plane, x1 is integral in the cone spherical coordinate. So actually, this question doesn't have sphere and dia tak ada sphere. Okay, it does not have sphere, but the question asks you to find this cone using spherical coordinate. Okay, kenapa? Sebab atas ni dia kata plane, z equals to 1. So actually, you want to find this cone punya volume, volume. Okay, so finding this cone punya volume guna cylindrical coordinate, you boleh dapat dah soal jawapan dia, which is equal to 5 over 3. So this will be your 2D. Okay, so this volume is z equals to x squared plus y squared. So the P here, 0 to pi over 4 lah. You tak perlu nak cari macam ni. Sebab you tahu, by default yang standard punya cone, angle untuk V dia mestilah pi over 4. Standard tu macam mana? Standard tu x squared plus y squared saja. Dia tak ada
any constant in front of it. Macam soalan nombor 9 tadi, dia ada constant which is 3 kan. So the phi will be different, no longer pi over 4.
So the theta is 4, 0 to 2 pi. So squared sine phi, 0 d theta. So now the question is rho. How to find rho when you don't have a, when you don't have a, what we call it, a sphere. Okay, because rho is an angle for sphere, kan? Tapi angle kat sini. Tapi, sorry, the rho is the radius for the sphere. But then your radius here is different. Kalau saya buat keluar, yang ni tadi satu, yang ni. You ada, this one lah, saya buat keluar yang merah ni. This one eh, saya buat keluar part ni.
Ini tadi awak punya phi kan?
Okay. And then you ada satu kat sini, and then this is your row. Okay, how to determine your row? Because kat sini, katalah kalau sini jadi row awak sama satu. Tapi as the angle changing, as the angle changes, your row also change kan? Kalau kat sini, katalah row kat sini, dia different. And then row kat sini pun dia different, panjang dia. And then until row here. So actually row, your row here is a function. It's no longer a constant, but it's a function of phi. Okay, kenapa phi? Sebab phi yang ada kat sini kita boleh kaitkan. Okay, dia ternampak dah phi. Okay, so you masih ingat setentang hypotenuse, all the trigonometry punya ni kan? Okay. You have here, if you have cos phi, your cos phi is actually equal to 1 over rho. Okay, sebelahan per hypotenuse. This is your 90 degree lah. 90 darjah tu, sebab sini 90 darjah. Okay. So what is your rho here? So you change lah, your rho must be 1 over cos phi, which is cosec. Second. Cosec is 1 over sine. So second. Okay, so actually your rho is from 0 until second phi. Because the rho has different value as the phi changing. Okay. You solve for this one. You'll get the answer lah. Lastly. Jawapan dia 5.3. Biasanya tak masalah sebab ni semua asing-asing kan. Okay, tapi tak boleh directly ni lah. Sebab mula-mula you integrate respect to rho. So you ada rho cos 3 per 3. You masukkan kosong hingga second phi. Sin phi masih ada. D theta d phi. The limit is 0 to pi masih ada. 0 pi over 4 masih ada. Okay, so second cos 3 phi over 3 minus 0 sin phi d theta d phi. Okay, second tadi apa? Second tadi 1 over cos. One over 3 tu saya buat keluar siap-siap. Okay, sign ni ke atas. And then you ada cos, cos 3 phi kan. Sebenarnya tadi saya buat turun bawah balik. Okay, and then this part you have to use substitution. kena tukar sebab tadi actually dia perlu integrate theta dulu, tapi bila saya buat macam ni, so saya tukar saja ni dia. Okay, so this one you want to integrate. Then you will get negative 1 over 3. U negative 3 plus 1, U negative 3 plus 1. D theta. Only D theta is what you have, and D free. Okay, before you substitute the value of 0 until pi over 4, you have to convert back u into cos. So you have negative positive, so 1 over 6. Cos 1 over cos squared and cos squared 3 0, pi over 4 and then say to terus integrate the theta, but theta to the effect. Okay, and then you tinggal masuk nilai sajalah, you try lah masuk nilai ke sini, get the answer whatever. So that's it for cylindrical and spherical coordinate. I assume you don't have any questions. But if you do, you may reach me through WhatsApp.